Hello, I'm John Hartley, salesperson with the RV Corral here in Eugene, Oregon. And today I get to show you our first 2020 Breeze. This is the 31-foot model, and it has the new 340-horse Cummins in it. Drove it yesterday. I was very impressed with how it drove. The previous motor was the 5-liter Cummins motor, 275 horse. This is 340 horse, 700 pounds of torque, improvement in performance of it, some other small changes around the RV, some new graphics, how they've laid out the paint job on it. This one was ordered with Mobileye, so accident avoidance system on it. Disc brakes on the front, air powered disc brakes, independent front suspension. This first compartment has your 12 volt circuit breakers here for many of the chassis house marriage things. The propane tank is right here. This is access to the storage on this side. So under bay storage, it's a raised rail chassis on it. This is to the back of the refrigerator. So the Breeze gets the seamless slide designs. So with most coaches, there's a seam here and a seam here on a slide room. This is made like a bathtub, no seams anywhere on it. So much less chance of leakage. Your service bay is here between the two slide rooms, so that's nice. You can get to it when you're camping. You don't have to be ducking underneath a slide room to get to it. And this is a 31-foot coach, so really a nice size to be able to take places. New positioning for the DEF tank on with this new motor change. DEF tank has its own little door here. Used to see the DEF tank in a compartment like this. That is the condensing radiator for the over-the-road air conditioning, and then air system connections and bleed-off area for manual draining of the air system. Your 50-amp shore cord with surge guard on it. One of the furnaces. Rear radiator coach, full walk-on, fiberglass roof on it. The Truma water heater came out on these, so this is an on-demand water heater. Works great, and it's propane powered, so you can get great hot water as much as, you know, if you're in a park or something, it'll create hot water all day long. This is where some of the electrical for the chassis and house connection stuff is. This is where our chassis batteries sit. This one is just access to where your tanks are sitting and some of the hydraulics for the slide rooms. The other side of the main bay. We ordered this one with outside TV. Has a sound bar up here. It's an LG TV. This is our other furnace, so 31-foot coach with two furnaces on it and on-demand water heating system. There's Class C's that are this kind of size. Another access to that main compartment, the inverter you can see up above. Those are the extra chairs for the freestanding table and chairs. And our house battery system. Those are on a rollout tray, so they're easy to maintain. There are four of them. So let's go inside. So some of the new things that came out was we got the digital dash like the bus has. So Tiffin's own logo comes up here, and you've got the digital dash system on it. This looks the same as the bus's digital dash. You've got a joystick over here that you can change settings on. Numerous settings, colors, things like that you can do with this. And then, because this is an air ride, air leveling coach, they gave us the same control like the bus gets. So, tells us whether we're level, we can manually level it, or we can leave it in an auto leveling mode. Shifter buttons up here, exhaust brake over here, has adjustable pedals. So, really a nice configuration to this, easy to drive. A lot of Class C's are this similar kind of length, 31 feet. So, dual power seats on this one. These are the controls for the hydraulic slides that are here that could contact these seats. These are so that when you're standing here, you don't, you can see where that slide is and not accidentally run it into the seat. The seats, of course, swivel, and this seat has the power recliner. So once it turns around, it's your recliner for watching TV. Sofa here is a hide-a-bed. You've got great storage up above, nice and deep. You've got roller shades with the mesh shade for privacy, and then the closeout shade. I think they've changed these window treatments a little bit. I think it's a nice change there. Electric refrigerator with the 2000 watt inverter. This works great. Powers it going down the road or anytime. These new fridges don't use a lot of power. You've got an electric fireplace, so this creates heat in the coach too. Big TV. Ducted air on top. This is Tiffin's quiet cool system where you have return air vents down this side and cold air, or if it's on a heat pump, on this side heat. Freestanding table and chairs on this one. New chair design. Very comfortable chairs. You've got lots of drawers on this side, all positive latching. And then over here, you have a computer workstation. There are plugins down inside the cupboard, so you can keep your laptop plugged in and charged up. Another pull-out tray below if you want to carry a printer. The table slides out for those other two chairs. Lots of nice deep storage in it. The galley has great counter space. You've got a three burner cooktop, which is propane, so dry camping with this coach would be easy. They've rearranged some things here to give us bigger cupboards up top and move the microwave all the way to this end. You've got three big drawers here. You've got a silverware drawer and other drawers. These are all wood on metal glides. Part of the multiplex wiring system here. You have control panels in numerous places, and then over here you have the main control panel. We'll get to that in a few minutes. Bathroom, 31 foot coach, got to have a pretty small bathroom. These move to this side, so easy access in and out of the shower. You have an adjustable height on your shower head. You've got a skylight there for additional headroom, which, as you can see, I don't need. Nice porcelain sink. Medicine cabinet with adjustable height shelves. And then a pocket door here for closing off the bedroom or the bathroom. There's another one for closing the bedroom, which we'll get to here in a minute. That's your travel latch from when you're going down the highway. So the multiplex system, you've got your home panel here, which from here you can see your tank levels, your batteries, you can start your generator. You have a lighting panel here with a master off and on switch, plus all the lights independently controlled. Your heating system, the roof vents, and then this is where we control this back slide out from. You have a pocket door here on the bedroom. Four big drawers, or actually three big drawers. This is going to be where our electrical is. Cupboards up top. All your TV controls are in here, your satellite system, LG TV. You've got closet across the back, and queen size bed. Nice deep cupboards up here. USB plugs on each side of the bed, 110 plugs on each side of the bed. Master light switch on the other side over there for controlling the lights and the room here or in the entire coach. Again, my name is John Hartley, and there's things I probably missed that you want to know more about. Please call me. My direct phone number, 541-953-5420. You can call or text to that number or send me an email, johnh@rvcorral.com. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video.